Steve. Thanks for stopping by to check out Salt TV. This time I'm going to show you the second half of my top new vinyl releases I picked up in 2018. But first, what I'm drinking this time, and I should have opened up two or three hours ago, is a Bang Potent Brain and Body Fuel Cherry Blade Lemonade. Zero calories. Super creatine, ultra CoQ10, BCA amigos, whatever that is. Amigos. You know what those BCA amigos are. Hopefully we've all got them. That's real different. More cherry than lemonade. If you're thinking that cherry and lemonade and lemons wouldn't necessarily mix, somehow they got them in this can together without fighting too much. Or maybe the fight that's going on is what's going on instead of the carbonation. Yeah, you know, because lemons, you know, lemons should taste more strong than cherry, but they made up for it by making the cherry just as strong as the lemonade, or really stronger, which is kind of good because, like, if you drink tea, you don't want to, you know, add tea to your lemonade. You usually want to add lemon to your tea, and that's kind of what's going on here. You got a cherry drink with a little added lemon. Pretty good. Of course, people drink that Red Bull garbage, and you know, this tastes a lot better than something like that. Yeah, usually things like this last longer than a Coke, than a pop also. Yeah, I don't say soda. Soda. A lot of times the, I don't know what's natural in here. You know, usually they try to add natural flavorings and stuff, but natural flavors. Yeah. So usually lasts a little longer than a pop. If anybody's tried that Coke vanilla orange, I thought about drinking that this time. It's very definite mix of a Coke with vanilla and orange in it. But, and you, I know you wouldn't think that orange Coca-Cola would sound good. You're gonna want to drink like an orange slice or something instead of a Coke. But it's a good mix, and the vanilla just kind of makes it mix in a smooth way. I thought about having that on here this time, but this is, everybody's seen that, so try it if you haven't had it. To me, it's better in the plastic bottle than in the can. A lot of times you can taste the can in the can and just is too strong, I think, or just not as smooth a taste anyway. So anyway, Bang. I could have made some kind of added metaphor here, but Hidden Hospitals, Liars. Hidden Hospitals is aptly named, as they're the band you've likely not heard of, yet are coming to your musical rescue. So what is it about this trio from the Windy City? It's not just the airy atmospheres. Virtually every track lifts your spirits with incredible melodies. It's why music is such good medicine. Now, where 2015's Surface Tension hit the heart hard with electric guitar crunch, Liars is even maybe more effective, incorporating more masterful electronics into the mix. While many bands struggle to write a listenable verse, chorus song, Hidden hospitals release themselves from such constraints to craft gripping music, which can cause feelings of joy even amidst one's hurts. Now, if you're familiar with the vinyl lovers over at Spartan Records, you've seen some rather sweet pressings, and these are no exception. With reverse stop covers, printed inners, a nice swamp bone gold splatter at 250 count, definitely check out Hidden Hospitals over at Spartan Records. Totally Mild, Her. Now, this is what I'm always hoping to find. Apparent music lovers making music, ending up with an album of well-crafted tracks. Well, pardon the comparison, but how Elizabeth opens this album with such vocal confidence is what really excited me about Björk's debut way back in the day. On this, the smooth, loungy sounds take one back to somewhat the early days of rock, where raw four-piece instrumentation expound out to airy and expansive pedal effects. Now, the green version looked great. However, I got this first run pink variant. I don't remember the count number. They're pretty low. But I could tell you a bizarre story about this cover and a mysterious cell phone call. And it appears Bathsheba here is trying to find out if it's her man in the adjoining room. Well, the band here just knows how to capture those rich feelings within the life of a relationship. Check out Totally Mild with Her. A lot of heavy this year. Vokonis, Old One Ascending. As a lover of all things Dragon, I kinda didn't care what this album sounded like. I was gonna add it to my collection. Fortunately, the sound is easily as interesting. Though Simon and Jante's vocals are of the one-dimensional sort, here their might matches the huge driving rhythms. The killer riffs amidst overdriven grooves make a trippy track such as Acid Pilgrim the undeniable heavy music anthem of the year. Really, all six tracks are 48 minutes of heaviness all sleep fans hunger for. Now, in reality, this is Vokonis' 2016 debut with its cartoonish cover art reimagined here for a proper 2018 release on Ripple. As you can see, with this vinyl 100 count heavyweight doom haze or ash red splatter variant, it begs to be played. Now, dig this insert. Now, is that a metal insert or what? That's what you want to get in your inside of your album, right? Well done, Ripple. Well done, guys. Now, I picked up their 2017 release, The Sunken Gin, on one of 50 rich blue wax. And if I can find it in here, had everything really nicely organized. There it is. And also the 100 count clear They have three different types of this. I don't remember what the others are. I think gray, maybe black or splatter or something. 100 count, clear 33 speed 7 inch with the title track Sunken Gin and Old One Live on side B. Huge sounds emanate. Woo-hoo. From the orange amps from the Swedish three-piece. I'm anxious to hear more by Vokonis. I love that album cover. May, multi-sensory aesthetic experience. Now, with this album, May finally achieved that stated name origination. Available with this album is a viewer I kept, I think, for your cell phone. I kept forgetting to get for the video files. All right, I'd show you that. But just go look it up for yourself on whatismay.com. Multiple hours worth of video content for that. I haven't even checked it out yet, just read about it. And one of these days I'm going to get around to that. This gorgeous album cover alludes to the dimensions produced throughout the 54 minutes of the two beautiful records housed in full color inner sleeves. Beautifully done. This is one that didn't necessarily need... With this type of art anyway, I guess. I mean, a band photo is always cool on the inside. But I think it's cheaper to do it with a double wide cover. But they did a nice job with it this way. This rich magenta purple theme. Carried through on one, and the clearest vinyl you'll ever see on the second. It's an allusion to the airy spatial dimensions throughout, with their full, deep, rich sounds, ebb and flow. While there are some instrumental moments, Dave's voice is so silky. It's an integral part of the caressing aesthetic in their sound. Now, since the beginning of 2001, May has always comforted us with the musical empathy, whether through hope or tragedy. The album brings with the track Sing, begins with the track Sing, where Dave says, "Sing to the melody now. When we try, we define the key now. We're going to get that harmony now. So, gonna get that harmony. So, won't you sing it with me? One, two, three now." Now, May has always had the right thing to say through the last two decades. While I raised four kids into adulthood and through every emotional roller coaster relationship, they've been an important soundtrack through the deepest experiences. Now, when in the track, "You Fall When You Hesitate," he says, "Time machine, I want to go back. To live in my past is exactly where I want to be. It's nostalgia haunting me." You just know, it's as if he knows you, you know? And then when he goes on to say, "She says to me that you fall when you hesitate. You crawl after tripping on your regrets. You fall in and out of love again. You fall. I'm really taken back to the relationships I could attach." Each May Copeland Further Seems Forever album to. The beauty of music is how it enhances the development of the purpose of our life. May are great at waxing nostalgic, yet I'm sure they know it can actually bring one back to the original first love, if you know what I mean. Speaking of, what's with the curious asterisks in the word God throughout the lyrics? Seems odd. Anyway, excellent, excellent album. Go to What Is May. They're on tooth and nail for this. Check it out. Altar Boys with No Substitute. Now, what constitutes a new album? Release date or when the record was written? Now, some albums take years to write, sometimes especially debut albums. Now, based upon the release date, what we have here is a long-awaited follow-up. And it's saying a lot to have an album originally written in the late 80s to early 90s be a top release in 2018, right? Yet, as I say, that's the thing about good music. And punk rock in particular never seems to lose its importance. If you're unfamiliar with the mic stand fronted band, it's rock placed somewhere between Billy Idol and, say, Bad Religion. Really, it's just switchblade comb and leather jackets. The appeal is slightly catchy. The appeal is simply catchy hooks and the high intensity of the passion in urgent messages. Punk rock has always been on a mission, some being more important than others. Make no mistake, this album is just as important as it's ever been. Yet with another high quality, low fidelity recording, this black line sleeve, black and red splatter, 180 gram vinyl is so well done. Altar Boys, No Substitute. The wait was well worth it, Mike. Stavesacre, 1995. Now, the cool car radio intro of this album reminds me of Resurrection Band song Waves from Awaiting Your Reply. Actually, the following song, The Dead Rejoice, does too a bit. Now, I reviewed this album on the Salt Zine Facebook page. So go read that exclusive review. Now, due to unfortunate circumstances, this may be the most underrated release on my list. Pretty much anyone into rock and roll of any kind will dig this album. With an order date of March 2016, a copyright of 2017, and a ship date of June 2018, it took way longer for this to come out than the average LP. But then, any Stavesacre fan continues to listen to their timeless albums ongoing. Through the unfortunate defunct crowdfunding company, the band stuck to it, and eventually our patience was rewarded with a signed copy. But really now, how many of your friends' signatures do you collect? The layout is great, with the worn look on this great cover, uncoated gatefold, and insert, about a 10-inch, 11-inch insert. It's not really lyrics, but quotes, kind of. I love when that happens. On brilliant, brilliant blue discs. See, these are not 45s, I believe. They're both the same brilliant blue discs. Beautiful. Seriously, get your hands on this album. Whether you're into Foo Fighters or Fugazi, you're going to love this Stavesacre 1995. Fifth Angel, the third secret. Now, how many of you spell angle, angel, and angel, angle? Be honest. One of the coolest metal releases of 2018 with a comeback album by Fifth Angel. It was definitely one I was most excited about. If it's 30-something years later, a band must have something great to offer. It's unfortunate people thought grunge was going to kill off metal. Well, it didn't. And back in 1988, I picked up this Megahertz compilation and was hooked on Fifth Angel and Sanctuary. This is one of those bands a metalhead vocalist strives for. I put original vocalist Ted Pilot way up there with RJBO. Now, being a metalhead this is what metalhead vocalist strives for. Now, being a dedicated doctor is what I was trying to say. Ted Pilot, the original vocalist, didn't return for this album. But the guitarist Kendall Bichelle, who joined for the second LP in 1989, sounds fairly identical, stepping up to the mic here. It's what you think, it's what you might imagine a mighty warrior angel would sound like, proclaiming the return of the Lord. Now, with a super nicely balanced drum mix, they just thunder. While the leads are tasteful, the music really holds up the melodies of the vocals in true metal fashion, a la Queensryche. With varying degrees of speed, each track is powerfully played in its own way. Now, shame on you, the second to last track, with its driving rhythm, will have you singing the chorus in your head all day. It's the power ballad, Can You Hear Me, that is reminiscent of the masterful moving classic tracks In the Fallout and Call Out the Warning from the compilation and from their debut album. You know, the art direction was great overall, with classic metal style painting by Sofia Dankova, a great layout, good typeface choices, and a gatefold of lyrics, and a black lined inner sleeve housing the appropriate fire splatter thick vinyl. Very well done. If you're gonna come back big. And Fifth Angel did. It's a great album. As they all are. They're all great albums. And I'll say it again. This is going to make me belch again. Nice spine for, I don't know if it blurs up if you get too close, right? See that. Nice spine for the Yob, Our Raw Heart. I waited a while to pick up this album, surprisingly, mostly because I thought, even though the color scheme looked great, the cover to me looked like someone stoned drew it. What is this? This turned out to be one of my favorite albums to listen to, albeit when I want to hear raw, aching, agonizing sound. Now, my sister-in-law's mother died around Christmas time, and I'll tell you, I was driving down the highway at night listening to this album, headed to see my parents when she told me she was driving home from the funeral. And it really caused this album to move me to tears thinking about it all. Of course, her musical choice was John Denver, maybe more therapeutic for her. Yet we were created to be able to experience mourning for a reason. It's one of the most intense times where we, through empathy, can experience love for others. Now, apparently there was much agony associated with the creation of this album, as Mike Scheid experienced an excruciating bout of diverticulitis, sending him to the brink of death, which ironically also happened to my own mother last year. It's dangerous stuff. Now, while with a track like the nearly 10 minutes in Reverie and its plodding off progressive timing and dad-gad tuning, it's one of those songs that makes me wonder how in the world do they do this, especially with those agonizingly slow tempos. I can place this album among some of the previous Doom albums, the best previous Doom albums out there, going all the way back, such as Paramecium's Exhumed of the Earth, Winter Album Into Darkness, or any the first couple of Cathedral. Now, I know in these days of self-serving false justice, many people out there have killed their own soul. Yet if anyone has half a heart, I ask you to just listen to a track like Beauty and Falling Leaves and see if it doesn't move you. This album really focuses on melody, really moving, mournful melody. Being spread across two records, they give you plenty of time to grieve. This album ends with a 14-minute instrumental epilogue, to coin a phrase, like a good classic album. As incredible as this album is, and the color palette is gorgeous, I think an image depicting diverticulitis in the center may have fit better with their other covers and been more interesting. Nevertheless, it is laid out rather nicely as Orion over at Relapse Records continues to be quite consistent with. There's various, of course, as Relapse does, various color palettes. I think there's a couple that are similar to this. This is the gold and purple splatter. Just, I mean, gold and purple, how can you go wrong with that, you know? Of course, when you put it on plastic, it's, you know, but it's still shiny and well done. Center of the gatefold is super nice. Kind of like that art a little bit better. But neither one, to me, I don't know. The colors look so great that it's actually kind of a cool cover. Whatever the case. Maybe if I just left the eyes out, but I don't know. It's still pretty cool. Freaking great album by Yob, Our Raw Heart. Stonefield, Far From Earth. Now, God thought man should not be alone and created woman. Anyone who's been in and out of a relationship knows a richer understanding of the dichotomy of desires. Now, there's a certain appeal with certain music. Rainbow's Richie Blackmore chose the musical desires of his wife in creating the exotic mystery and the medieval sounds that they produced together. The same sensory appeal soothes the ears while listening to one of last year's favorite albums by Ruby the Hatchet, Planetary Space Child. Well, there's a 60s trip threaded throughout this album. It never falls into an incoherent psychedelia. Instead, They prefer to wow you with simple yet powerful powerful hook, oftentimes giving him as much homage to Iommi as to Blackmore. It's yet another example of how women can be just as fierce as charming. Now, with a pirate's press, press count of 2,000, you should be able to get your hands, have a good chance of getting your hands on one of these creamy bone colored LPs. Now, adding to the classic design is an embossed, yes, this is embossed, where is that, die cut cover to match with the flippable hard color insert. It's a great design, I love this. With Sleeps, the Sciences was a cool surprise. This Stonefield album was far and away a much bigger, more enjoyable surprise for me. Not in that something like this can't be done, but that it seems rare. Now, it may make sense that four siblings could gel so well, but how often does it happen, really? And this here is no partial example of space rockery. This is a full and complete package. The grooviest of style and look and sound from the Stonefield of Australia. Now this, ASG, Survive Sunrise, easily, hands down, the album of the year, 2018. I don't remember if I'd heard them previously, but I'm gonna give my bud Eric Brown big props for suggesting this band, All Systems Go, to me a couple years ago. After seeing this gorgeous Art Deco style gatefold cover and hearing the title track, I immediately pressed purchase. Around the same time, about the beginning of the summer, I also got a new trail bike,
a Fuji Absolute 2.1, shown here with my Camaro at Waldo Bikes.
Now, the first thing I listened to was this album on Bandcamp with huge hook-laden melodies emphasized by massive bombastic grooves. These tunes are meant to inspire, conquering the biggest of waves, the toughest trails, gnarly half pipes, and burning rubber with your babe in your boogie van. Now, if you don't feel great after listening to this album, just check your pulse. With their own signature desert rock sound, this band finds many creative ways to grow into a crescendo where Jason's voice lifts you up higher and higher. Now, the lyrics are spread across the gatefold here. The art is carried out nicely throughout. Very well done. Nice color matched 45s. 45s. Get those lows. Should love it when that happens. Anyway, great, great album. Check this album out by ASG. All Systems Go by Survive Sunrise. Well, there you have it. After dozens and dozens of hours spent in days and weeks and months and years, seems like, I'd like to see your top albums for the year. So leave me a comment with your like, your thumbs up. Now, this is Steve with Salt Zine. Thanks for stopping by. Now go out there and use what God blessed you with to go do something cool to bless others. Right on. Right on.